In my earlier YouTube days, last year and the year before, I did a fair amount of book reviews. I didn't get a lot of views on those, but actually I did get a couple of people say, I really like book reviews. So I'm going to do a book review for the old days. This one's on Todd Eldredge's book, Cardiovascular Wellness Management Success Plan. Todd, all due respect, I think you could have come up with a better title, but it's a great book, and I'll we'll go over the details on why. And I also will talk about why you've got that title that's a little bit confusing. Now, I will say this. This was a bestseller. So Todd, my colleague, the CIMT guy, is an Amazon bestseller. Now, speaking of people that don't like stuff, most people don't like that old technology where I was holding printed documents in front of the screen and talking to them. But actually, again, there's quite a few folks that have said, you know what, I miss the old school lack of technology. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to do a book review using the old school lack of technology. Couple of things. Todd starts off, he engages you quickly with his humanity. He talks about how as a 15 or 16 year old boy, he got the bad news that his brother had died in a car wreck. Now, how did he hook that back to CIMT? He probably could have been a little bit more emphatic, but the point that he was making is, gosh, you know, we've got the amount of what, several Vietnam walls happening every week or two with heart attack and stroke, where most of these people, at least half of them, are being taken without any warning at all. That's a terrible thing to happen for family members. So again, a great way of engaging viewers. Then he talks about his other brother, who was a thin, very athletic airline pilot, who had some problems, which Todd picked up looking at his CIMT. He gets into some good, fairly good description of atherosclerosis. Now, I guess this is probably an interesting place to talk about. It's a good review. Most of the folks on my channel have this level of review. Again, it would be worthwhile to take a look at. Then a good discussion on blood components, cardiovascular indicators of risk. Now, back to that comment about who's his audience for the book. Weird thing, his audience for the book is doctors. It's not so much written to the public. I can tell you, again, given the conversations that we have on this channel, most of the viewers of this channel will be very very conversant with what Todd's talking about here. Part of what that shows you is how little the typical doc knows about the mechanisms of plaque development and cardiovascular risk. Now, why does Todd see his audience in this book as doctors and not consumers? Well, and patients. You may remember this in the video that I did with Todd. It was a long video, and unfortunately, a lot of people said it was great video. A lot of technicians, one technician, for example, said it was the best video he'd ever seen. But I think just the timing itself, being over an hour, was intimidating. So we got great reviews, but not a lot of people saw it. I'm thinking about breaking it up into sections so people, it won't seem so intimidating. But the point behind it was I got into this discussion of DTC, direct to consumer, with Todd. He and I had discussed it before, but you could tell he kind of stammered around. And here's why. Todd lives in a world where there basically across the U.S. you find docs who are doing these CIMTs. They'll have a CIMT day like once a month, every 2 months, 3 months for their patients. And Todd, unfortunately, although he's got a great company, a fantastic test that he does a really good job with, so very few docs know and understand it. That's his world, helping docs understand what they could be doing for their patients. So, again, part of the Maytag repairmen were supposed to be the loneliest people in town. And again, the demographic that watches this channel may remember that commercial. Unfortunately, Todd's maybe one of the loneliest men in the country as well, his product doesn't need repair, but because nobody recognizes it, nobody understands it. there's a couple of, maybe the best quote in the whole video is this: in short, many physicians treat risk factors, not disease. Very frustrating and, again, difficult to get your head around. I'm just going to cover a few other items. It's interesting, he worked with a fellow named Frank Ruderman, who used to be the CEO for Berkeley Heart Labs. Many of you who've been in this space, like John, may recognize the name Berkeley Heart Labs. they built a very interesting, very helpful wellness VIP website. It's a website that goes into some details on the basic cardiovascular risk factors, blood studies, things like that. And as I've considered opening up my practice again, that's one of the things I'm thinking about, is using this free website that Todd and Frank Ruderman have built to start helping my patients track their own information. This website does go into detail in terms of lifestyle recommendations. It's a very, very interesting opportunity. But I think it's like CIMT. It's there. It's a great thing, and people are not using it, not aware of it. He's got a good chapter, again, on how things operate in terms of CIMT and what it is. For me, by far, the best part was his literature review, his discussions on what you see in the literature, what some of the pros and cons, what some of the pitfalls are. That's what got me going on the one of the videos that I created recently that looked at mean max versus total CIMT. Mean max, mean meaning average, and max is peaks. In other words, and Todd and I had this discussion, looking at the average of peaks in a CIMT versus looking at the arterial age. In the end of the day, both of them are very helpful in terms of prediction. Were there any other significant components that I would say you want to take a look at? Yeah, again, you go into more chapters on deep literature and very helpful literature regarding CIMT. For example, does serial CIMT predict risk? And again, this is an area. We've had several discussions and several videos on CIMT versus coronary calcium. And this is one of the major advantages of CIMT. It's far better at predicting risk going up and going down using serial or repeated studies. lessons from other clinical trials, et cetera, et cetera. Again, very good book. It was a real eye-opener for me, and I do this for a living. So thank you, Todd. And gosh, you know what? I wish some people would begin to understand a little bit more about what you do. This is the thing that you're seeing here. The background is the author page on Amazon, where, again, my friend Todd is now a best-selling author. If you hit the like button, and for sure if you subscribe or share, the algorithm reads that as a strong message that humans think this is interesting and important information. And the algorithm can share it more than any of us humans. speaking of sharing, one of the best ways of sharing is on social media. We've got active Facebook, Instagram, and LinkedIn activities going on right now. We've recently started up things in Pinterest and Twitter, so we'd love to see you there. Check us out. Finally, with over 500 videos, a lot of people are saying, I can't find this video or that video. Our new social media manager, Kim Hermosa, is starting to work on ways to help with that. So join the community. You can click on the links below, and you can get a little bit better access. Thank you again for your interest.